true and what was false. Right, so let the false. Ladies and gentlemen, you are so welcome. As Jan said, we did something very similar in Loch Arbour a couple of years ago. And at that point, we vowed we'd never do it again. And then I think we had some glasses of wine after the event, and this is the result. What I want you to understand from what we're doing this evening is the people who are seated at the table in front of you are genuine experts. These are people who, within their field, have the highest level of regard from their fellow colleagues and their peers. So it's not that we've just gone out and picked anyone off the street. You have got the best of the best of the best. And let's see what they can do for the teammates. So first of all, it is my pleasure to introduce at the far end Mr. John Dunn, who is the Procurator Fiscal for the East of Scotland. So if anybody is going to keep us on track as to what we are required to do with our legal proceedings this evening, then this is very much John's field. He joined the Crown Office in 1985, and he became the Procurator Fiscal Deputy from Tavely in 1987. At that point, for the first time, he was the convict of a lot of the criminal investigation, and he spent a considerable number of years associated with that highly important, highly political, dreamily high-profile case. In 2005, he became the area Procurator Fiscal for Ayrshire, and in 2007, he was appointed Deputy Crown Agent. I told you, we are dealing with real experts here tonight. In 2011, he was the area Procurator Fiscal for Glasgow and the West of Scotland before taking his current role in 2014. Dr. Carly Cahill, is senior lecturer in history at Glasgow Caledonian University. She has held research fellowships at the University of Guelph and at Yale. She is a highly respected researcher within her field, and she is the co-chair of the Royal Society of Edinburgh's Young Academy of Scotland. Her research interests include religion, national identity, and migration of the Scottish and the Irish context. Professor Lee Dickday. Oh, what can I say? She's now worried. Professor Lee Dickday is a fellow of the Royal Society of Edinburgh. She is director of research in the centre where I work as well, of the Centre of Anatomy and Human Identification at the University of Dundee. She is a forensic chemist. And you might have a clue as to her importance to the evening when you realise that she specialises in the area of the investigation of fire, explosions, and clandestine drugs, but we're not going to go down that route. It's not unaware, anyway. She is chair of the European Working Group for Fire and Explosion Investigations, and she's vice chair of the Scientific Advisory Board to the International Criminal Court. She has more fellowships than I think most charities have, and so we won't read them all out, but she's a fellow of many, many learned societies. And finally, last but by no means least, somebody I've had the privilege of working with for a great number of years is Professor Dick Shepherd. Dick Shepherd is a consultant in forensic pathology and has been a Home Office registered pathologist for, hard to believe, 30 years. Far too young for 30 years. His testament reads like something out of the newspaper, and so just a few of them give you some idea of his level of expertise. The Bloody Sunday inquiry, the death of Diana Princess of Wales and Mr. Gurney Al-Fayed, the death of Dr. David Kelly, the terrorist attacks on the World Trade Center, the Bali bombing, the Hungerford shootings, the Clapham train accident, the Marchioness disaster, the London bombing from 7/7, the multiple shootings in Cumbria, and so it goes on and it goes on. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a truly exceptional talent. And what they're going to turn these incredibly big brains of theirs towards this evening is the question that was on there a few minutes ago that says, who's responsible for the murder of Lord Browning? Can I take just a little straw poll? Just before we start, not in any way influence you as to what might happen. We're going to try and move everybody along fairly quickly so that we make sure we get everything we need to get done before the end of this evening. But we are going to follow some fairly well-established procedures, and Mr. Dunn is going to take us through what the process is going to be for this evening. Mr. Dunn.
Well, thanks for having me. The first thing I'm going to do